Yo, what is poppin' YouTube? Yeah, boy, Alexandros here. You already know Fellas, the biggest icon in the space. Now also in the NFT space. Hear me out, okay? Hear me out, guys. Today we are going to have a look at the Empire Digital project about NFTs. And you've been lately loving those NFT-related projects, guys. And I'm not even surprised because, like, come on. Those are future of art. Let's be honest here, okay? So yeah, the Empire, guys, that's what we'll be reviewing today. I hope that you will be enjoying this. A lot of information to talk about. I have pulled up like 10 pages, yeah, I think so, or even more, with all the informations. We will go briefly through white paper. They also have one pager. Yeah, we'll basically go over everything. So stay till the end, guys. You won't regret it, that's for sure. But just before we jump into it, I need to let you know that I'm not a financial advisor. You should always do your own research and you should always do your own due diligence, because I don't take any responsibility for your actions. And now, with that being said, I can briefly tell you what VEmpire is. So VEmpire is a DDAO gaming protocol invading Decentraland and the metaverse, which is also providing users with a play to earn NFT card trading game. Okay, so it's on play to earn as well. They have the cards on OpenSea. We'll go over the OpenSea in a second. And VEmpire's goal is to highlight projects at risk of becoming centralized or who have already fallen victim to it. So VEmpire DDAO seeks to combat the monopolization and monetization of the metaverse space, whilst also leading the fight against unfair or unequal protocols. So the front line in the fight against centralization. This is the website, okay? It looks pretty simple, but I like the, you know, theming of this. I like the topic. The NFTs are also cool and they are kept in the similar style, so that's something that is definitely nice. First, what we can see is some mentions here, as you can see in press. So we have Yahoo Finance, Forbes, OpenSea, MarketWatch, Benzinga, and Bitcoinist. Pretty cool. Then we have documents, we also have their newsletter, and we have social medias, which, as you can see, they are active on pretty much every single one, okay? Like, if you think about social medias, I don't know, they have them all, okay? They have them all. So you already know that I will invite you to join the Twitter and join the 22,000 other followers here. They are really active and nice, announcing some cool partnerships, announcing some cool events that are happening. As you can see, they are also doing AMAs. They have, of course, Transparent Team. I was lacking the word. Transparent Team, as you can see, Dominic Ryder, CEO and founder, they are doing the AMAs, okay, which is pretty nice. This one is actually tomorrow, so you might still tune in for that one, as the video will go live on 23rd, I think, so that's easy. And yeah, ladies and gentlemen, you can tune into their AMA. You already know that I like AMAs, and I really enjoy when projects do it, because it kind of brings the community together. You can ask the questions and you can integrate with the team itself, which is really, really nice. By the way, they are audited, as you can see. You know that I'm showing you all the best projects, only the audited ones. So yeah, VEmpire Digital has been audited absolutely by Solidproof. So that's cool. So that's it when it comes to the Twitter, Telegram. You can join as well, 9000 members discussion channel. They also have some language-based channels. This one is Chinese. They also have Indian one. So if there is someone watching me from China or India, then you can also go ahead and join their dedicated language channels. All right, now we can jump into the mission section here on the website, which is pretty nice. We have a nice little introduction here, which is written by Dominic, by obviously the CEO. So we have the introduction and context. As a late millennial, my recollection of the Great Recession is foggy. As a teenager during that time, I remember constantly hearing about it on the news and thinking that credit crunch would make a great cereal. It is only after moving into financial services I began to understand just how much the world was railroaded by rating agencies, investment firms, and banks. Yeah, this is basically a really nice, you know, explanation of the thing, and then he's talking about how he got into this space and all that kind of stuff. Some information about NFTs too, and how they are getting popular. Definitely worth a read. We are not going to be reading from page like all the info, because that would be pointless. As you can, you know, you can see it. You can literally pause the video or go to the website and check it out by yourself. But yeah, really nice, and shout out to Dominic for having this up here and readable for everyone. What I wanted to focus on is the NFTs themselves right now, because they are definitely worth showing. In my opinion, they look sick. So yeah, this is their OpenSea, as you can see, the Empire, the Founding Soldiers, 240 items. The floor price is 0.45 ETH, and that's the volume that they have generated, which is pretty nice, almost 61 ETH. And this is still the beginning, okay? This could go, I mean, this could definitely grow a lot. So the first wave, the Soldiers of the Empire. After years of quietly building military strength and governing the surrounding areas, the time has come for the Empire to expand its borders and seek out new places to rule. The Empire has set its sights on Decentraland, where the leadership is falling short of what the people deserve. Using the efficient military training earned over time and the passion of its people, the Empire will soon encompass everything in its path. Alright guys, and let's have a look, let's appreciate those NFTs because they really look cool. So that's how they look. They are in form of a card, because again, this is an NFT play to earn card game. That's what it's supposed to be. You have some auctions, you have some cards that you can, you know, get to buy now. For example, this one, right? And then you also have the auctions. I literally clicked on an auction, but anyways, you also have this, for example, right, which is a buy now offer for 0.45 ETH. And for example, we have reinforcements here. Pick a card from your legion and put it in your hand. This is number 50 from 100, so as you can see, those are also limited in supply. Obviously they have rarities, this one is common, and then obviously the lower number, the more it could potentially be worth. But that's basically, you know, the number of cards that there is. This one is 8 from 100. You have the description, you have the trading history of these cards, right, how much it went for, how much it was listed for, the whole trading history. And as you can see, they also have the more expensive ones. This one is, for example, 15 from 20. Magnus, Master Spy. Alright, and this one is 10 ETH. so yeah, this definitely is quite a bit expensive. But yeah, they have wide variety of those, which is nice. And in my opinion, the design is on point here with those cards, especially if it's, you know, about an NFT card game, then they definitely fit into the design, into the topic. That's what I feel like. If you want, then you can also go ahead and check those out. Maybe you can buy yourself one, obviously up to you. So yeah, there is different characters also, as you can see. So yeah, pretty cool. You have explanations of what each card does and that kind of stuff. All right, then we have the team. So again, Dominic Ryder, he's the CEO, Chief Executive Officer, as you can see. Then we have Mike Ryder, who is COO. We have Harvey Woods, who is working for marketing and operations management. And then also they have technology partner, 0xBlock, as you can see, which is, well, reliable. 0xBlock have worked for countless blockchain projects, as well as the team boasting significant clients, including JP Morgan and Goldman Sachs. They have a team of over 40 developers with a huge array of knowledge. And we have Warren Rogers here, who is their advisor. Obviously, you have LinkedIn's for all of those people here, so you can check them out directly, which is really, really nice. And yeah, again, it's transparent team, this BSC space, I mean BSC space, not BSC space, in this case it's ERC, but in general, okay, the NFT space, that's what I wanted to say in the first place, just used to, you know, BSC projects. Anyways, this NFT space is also usually lacking the transparency, and those guys are providing this transparency. They are transparent team, they have their LinkedIn's, and it's really nice, and I respect that they decided to do it. So that's the one thing about the team. Then we also have the mission, which I was talking about. Now this is pretty cool, the integrations and partnerships. So as you can see, they have Chainlink here, MXC Global, Polygon, Oriana Ventures, Carbon Blue Innovations, Moonwhale, AKG, ICO Pantera, and Prime Block Ventures. So solid partnerships, solid integrations here, definitely. I mean, Chainlink, okay, and MXC Global, pretty cool. What else do we have here? We have a NFT handbook, which has 49 pages. That's in case you want to get into the NFT and the game itself. As you can see, they have how to play here, how the game works, okay? They have all the explanations of all of the characters, of their features as well, right? So this basically has 49 pages because it's, you know, mainly explanation of the characters, how they work, of the cards, as you can see, okay? So that's the thing here. So that's basically the manual or the instruction, whatever you like to call it. Then we have the white paper, which is actually 20 pages in, and I would really recommend you to go ahead and check out the white paper. It's also written by Romulus and Remus, so pretty cool. And yeah, the white paper is really in detail, 20 pages, and you also have some cool informations here that I've been at least looking around before making the video, and it looks solid to me. Again, it would be like 1 hour long video if we would be talking about the whole white paper and analyzing everything here. So in case you want to check it out, which I really recommend you to go ahead and at least briefly check, okay, you have a page of contents here, you can decide whatever you want to look up and then go ahead and do it. It's really worth it, and there is a lot of cool and interesting informations in this white paper. In case you are lazy, as I am, you have one pager. Yeah, you have one pager. And on one pager you have all the most important informations in one place, you could say. You have about the project, right? What is it about? The Empire is entirely focused on the true decentralization of decentralized autonomous organizations. The project is dedicated to fighting back against so-called decentralized projects that have somewhat become centralized. Projects like the Empire are required to ensure that the market continues to remain decentralized as it develops. And we are all, or at least majority of us, are looking for this decentralization in crypto projects, so those guys are going to provide it. We have some listing information, as you can see, token release schedule, then we again have the team with biography of COO and CEO, people from 0x Block, the integrations, where they were featured, allocations. We have the roadmap, okay? We have the roadmap, and quarter one is really exciting because we will be looking at cross-chain functionality here, which I'm really excited about, because they might also get into the BSC, which would be sick. Top 3 trading card series on OpenSea, and then quarter two we will be looking at multiple tier 1 exchange listings. So your favorite question, when Binance, might be answered here. I don't know, okay? Like, I'm speculating that they could be trying to get onto Binance and some other tier 1 exchanges. If they will develop good enough, then it's definitely in the range of possibilities. Also Solana functionality with Atlas staking, as you can see. And yeah, they will release second game in quarter 3 2022, so there is still some time to this date, but it's cool and exciting to see that they are ambitious and they will be working on a second game too. Quarter 4 we are still looking at fully functioning staking platform and an NFT game, this one NFT play to earn card game, which I'm really excited about, and this could be definitely something cool with those cards if they can come up with a nice idea. I mean, they already came up with this idea, but with nice execution of this idea, that would be insane. They are also listed and tracked on CoinMarketCap. If you want, you can add them to your watch list. Not currently logged in, so can't really do it, but I will. What I will do on the other hand is vote them good here. They are on multiple exchanges, which is pretty cool. The BKX is definitely the one that they generate most volume on, but then we have Uniswap, MXC2, Bitmart, 0x Protocol, as they also have the advisory team from here, so they are listed here. And 1inch, which doesn't really have a volume, but I guess if you use 1inch, you can also buy here. Anyways, 12 cents with 20 million market cap, still a lot of room to grow, still a lot of potential. If you go to their DEX tools, I think it's actually 21. I thought it's a bit less. But yeah, that's the chart right now, which dropped a little bit from 22 cents. I mean, the market today is just kind of, I mean, yeah, today maybe it's recovering, which you can also see by this candle here. It went up quite a good bit, I think 20%-ish. Yeah, we have it here, 32%-ish. Okay, cool. But anyways, with the market recovering, this could definitely skyrocket in the price. In my opinion, there is definitely potential for VAMP to be worth $1 after, you know, getting the game released, okay? They are also doing some good marketing, influencer marketing, but also other forms of marketing. And after releasing the whole product, they could definitely be looking at really nice price increase, which this is, again, my opinion. You should always do your own research, your own analysis, keep that in mind. You can buy this on Uniswap easily, okay? One Ethereum can get you 25, almost 1,000 of this token. So if you will be interested in the Empire, guys, link down below, you know where to find them. Let me know in the comment section what do you think, and see you in the next videos coming out.